Hi everyone, it's Roseanne. I'm still playing with the satin and I'm still trying to figure out ways to use this stuff. So I came up with making a really super quick and easy shabby bow. So I'm going to show you how to do those. I'm sure there's tons of videos on YouTube, but this is my version, I guess. So this piece of, I just cut a piece of material. It doesn't have to be straight. And as you can see, it's all wrinkled, but I'm okay with that. No biggie. And I'm talking quietly because Scrubby is sleeping. So I'm going to fold the piece in half. This is about 10 inches, maybe 11. And then there's a folded edge and an open edge. You're going to measure where the half point is, and then you're going to make the folded edge or section a little bit bigger than this edge. So go over maybe a half of an inch, and then, I don't have thread on my needle, so now I got to thread my needle. Really quick here. And it's very, very little sewing. Super easy. Okay, let me thread the needle here. Thread your needle, tie your knot. For those of you who don't sew very much, this is really easy. Okay, so I've got my knot. Let's go back to this. So we have the folded edge is going to be the section is going to be a little bit bigger than half. So as you can see, this is bigger than the side. And you want the wrong sides together. Just fold it in half with the pretty side showing. Normally when you sew, you put the pretty sides together, but with this, you don't. You want the pretty side out. So, I'm just gonna make a really quick little seam here, a little quick running stitch. And then I'm just gonna tie it off here. I'm gonna make another knot and then stick that somewhere so it doesn't end up on the floor. Okay, so you have your little side, and see, I still moved it over. Now that's halfway. It should be about right here, but it's okay. It's only a video, so then you're gonna open up your open ends. You're gonna grab your loop and push it down like that. See, super simple. And then I have little scraps here, so with the scrap you can make it as skinny or as wide. I'm gonna try something here. Yeah, that's too wide, so I'm gonna make it skinnier here. Cut it in half. Okay, so you're gonna fold it like this, or open it. And what I like to do is kind of try to straighten it out. Grab the glue, and there's no glue. Boy, I was ready for a video, huh? Okay, there we go. So put some glue, just a little bit. And again, pretty side showing towards you. And then I'm just gonna squeeze this all the way around. and put a little bit of glue right there. I'm just wrapping it. Oops. Okay, I'm just wrapping it. And then I'm going to cut the end here. So see, now you have your little bow. Very simple. I don't know where that came from. But because it's the satin material, now you can shabby it up just with your nail, the edges. And then with these, you know, all you have to do to make them even is put a cut right here or a slit right in the middle. Let me get my little scissors, they're sharper. So just make a slit right in the middle and evenly. And then you go from one corner and then the other corner, meet in the middle there. And that way you know you have it even. This is going to be, you know, right in the center. And then you just fuzzy it up. And then here we go again. Cut down the middle. Cut to the end. And you can adjust your bow. And I think this is not, it's too long, so I'm just going to make it a little bit shorter. And there you go, my dears. A very quick, super simple shabby bow. And then what I did was I just put some glue and did the old, you know, pour the glitter on there. Put some hot glue there. You could do it along the edges. You could do it wherever. And then I just wanted to show you really quick. I was making flowers. And there's the Roxy Berry in the center. Look at how pretty that came out. So, yeah. Still playing with the satin. And I'm definitely going to be using it all up for sure, because this has been so much fun. Nice little project in between, you know, your big projects, kind of mindless. And I like to do these little projects and make just a bunch so that later you have a bunch of embellishments already made, and you don't have to stop your project just to make an embellishment. And then one other thing is, my sissy Judy suggested that I paint, or that I glimmer spray my leaves or my satin. And so I did that with the leaves. Good idea, Judy. And look at how pretty that looks. So here is a, let me see, I have a bunch of leaves here. Here is a leaf that is regular satin, and there's one that is sprayed with the homemade glimmer spray. So, this light is horrible. There you go. Really, really pretty. And I'm sure I could kind of do the same. Let's see. Now, this one isn't my homemade one. This one is a Lindy's that I bought from someone, and I don't know what color it is. Black Orchard Silver, Orchid Silver. So let me just spray. And it will dry pretty fast. So you got a little shabby coloring, like a mousse tea dye. And sparkle also. See the sparkle there? So, yeah. I hope you like my little quick and easy bow. I'm still fooling around with this stuff. Oh, one more thing. It's made a little embellishment. Isn't that cute? With the leaf. This is a seam binding rose. And then this is just an applique. I don't have any more of these big ones, but just a little lace applique and a little lace heart. So, really cute. Really, really, really cute. So, yeah. Have fun with your satin, my dears. Thank you for stopping by and visiting me today. Thank you for your sweet, sweet, sweet comments, as always. And stay tuned for more videos. I have lots and lots that I'll be uploading because of my virus. I do still have a virus. I still have issues with my emails. I'm sorry. I don't know how to fix it. And that's it. Anyway, thank you everyone again for stopping by, and God bless everyone. Bye-bye.